Hello, my name is Bolorma. I am Dr. PhD student at School of Public Health, Loma Linda University. Today, I would like to share alcohol control policy in Mongolia. Nowadays in Mongolia, that during last 10 years, alcohol consumption is really not decreasing. It is year by year is increasing, and especially among women, young girls, the consumption is increasing, and more younger people starting to use alcohol in early age. That is really alarming among general population, because why alcohol consumption increased in Mongolia during last several last years, like because of there is a lot of socioeconomic factors in place. That before 1990, during socialist period of time, in Mongolia were very limited access of alcohol products, and density of selling point was very less, and workplace regulation was very strict, and all those positive things was existed during socialist period of time. Then economic transition started since 1990. Then therefore easy access for alcohol products is created, in density of selling points and low price of product, low tax and variety of choices, increased production, all those factors really influenced for increase for growth of consumption. And there is also some unemployment situation in my general population and mobile population, and very weak workplace regulation and poor social service, and all those things is influenced for increasing of general population alcohol consumption. But during 10 years in Mongolia, there is several achievements regarding alcohol control policy. Alcohol tax is little bit year by year is increasing, but still not sufficient. And city government office selling tax for alcohol and tobacco product is created, and this taxation goes for funding. And also health promotion foundation we established, and this foundation allocated tobacco and alcohol some percentage of taxations. And also we have a age limit 21, under 21 is banned to access for alcohol products. And also we have a limit of production and selling by introducing of license permission by local government office, but still the number of production and selling points is very high comparing to local density of population. And the limit of importing by taxes also exist in the last several years. Also drink driving enforcement is improved, legal fines increased and improved. Those actions is really influenced somehow for the consumption. And also every month, each of the months, the first day each of the month is no alcohol day, and every places not selling alcohol products. That is the role example. And but still we have a challenges for alcohol control policy. We have very weak law enforcement mechanism, even though we have positive some alcohol control policy. The still taxes is still low compared to other countries. We still need to increase alcohol, all types of products tax. And also density of alcohol selling point is very high compared to population number, and open display of alcohol products is the somehow very direct advertisement for targeting young people. And also alcohol product marketing through TV is still ongoing. That means we need to ban all types of advertisements. And also alcohol product promotion through sport events is still happening, targets for youth, and lack of collaboration between local government office initiative for multi-stakeholder on alcohol control issues. And therefore we need really strong collaborations between different multi-stakeholder partners. And also, even though we have Health Promotion Foundation, and this money goes not only for alcohol control programs, but it is a huge amount of money goes different types of health programs under Ministry of Health, because Ministry of Health controls this foundation, and therefore this agency, this this foundation needs to be separated from any ministries, and this foundation must be work as an independent agency to allocate, to spend this money for only against for alcohol and tobacco issues, and no financial support for research on alcohol control policy and treatment options. This is also creates also challenges, and no regulation for connecting academic institution and clinical level settings to improve the addiction therapy. And there is also lack of human resources for alcohol control programs at national level. And human resources is very important for sustaining the program, and very effectiveness of the program really influenced by trained, very specialized, high technical experts on alcohol control issues. And there is also inspection agency and police department key staff work responsibility is also double, and these key people need to work very effective way. And for near future, we really need to increase alcohol taxation, and also 100% ban of all types of alcohol product advertisement need to be legalized, and ban of sponsorship by alcohol industry for culture and sport events and their teams. It must be as soon as need to be implemented. The recent evidence, like recent end of July, recent soccer national league competition, we saw online picture how a local alcohol industry sponsoring very famous soccer league team by their t-shirts and all those banners and everything's promoting alcohol brands. And also nowadays we need to change of closing hours of bars, nightclubs, and alcohol selling points, and this will be reduce much of consumption, because this is already approved in many other countries. For example, in New Zealand, they really using this type of policies. And also we need to ban of open display of alcohol products at the selling point, and we need to ban of producing alcohol product with smaller size, because even though we increase the price of the product, then if there is small size of alcohol products, then it means small size of product have a less very cheap price, and then this type of products attracts poor people and minor minors as well. And also we need to encourage strict workplace regulation to encourage if employees have alcohol issues, and then through workplace regulation we need to encourage for them early screening and early access for treatment. And also we need to improve healthcare for addiction therapy and through health insurance support, and also other alternative service opportunities. And also we need to create regulation in the legalization to encourage young public health professionals to involve for law enforcement programs. Thank you very much for your attention.